In this video, I want to continue talking about YouTube and how you can monetize a smaller channel to make money with or without Google AdSense. And we talked about this in the previous video. And so if you haven't seen part one of this video, then you should watch that one before. And then come back to this video just so everything makes sense, because you may get confused if you only watch this video. So here's the link to that video. I'm leaving it on the screen right now. And you can pause this one and go watch that one and then come back to this video. Now, in the previous video, I talked about how you could get free marketing and traffic from YouTube, and you wouldn't have to pay anything out of pocket. And this was great, considering that otherwise you'd have to pay for Facebook ads or Google ads to get traffic to your website or your products online. Now, when creating a YouTube channel, you have two main ways that you can go about doing this. And the options are to create a branded channel or a personal branded channel, which is similar to what I'm doing here right now by recording these videos myself. And then the other main option was to create a faceless YouTube channel where you can create content or videos that either only have your voice and not your face, or maybe they don't have either. Now, you can use clips from other videos, or you can use clips and photos, and depending on the niche, this can be anything. It could be showcasing resorts, cruise ships, do-it-yourself videos, top 10 videos, and just about anything. Now, these two types of channels have their own sets of pros and cons, and so before you actually create a channel to monetize it, based on what we talked about in the previous video, I want you to think about the pros and cons of each and then decide which one or which type of channel you want to create, because maybe a personal branded channel may be better for you or your business or monetizing content on YouTube. Now, a very quick reminder here, if you are new to this channel and you're watching one of my videos or just seeing me for the very first time, my name is Ian, and I post videos here on YouTube every single day on topics relating to making money and personal finance. So if you'd like to see more videos like this one, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. I'll really appreciate it. And also consider subscribing to this channel and turning on all the notifications. And that way you'll be able to get the updates every day when I post a new video here. Now, whenever I mention creating a YouTube channel, most people will tell you that they don't think they could be on camera and they're afraid of showing their face, and so they don't want to have to deal with rude comments or maybe people going to their other social media and sending them hateful messages. And some people just don't want to be on the internet, and I get that. And although I'm making this video right now and you've probably seen multiple videos of me, I'm actually not a very extroverted person. Far from it. This is why I don't usually smile in my videos, and I don't try to make funny jokes or anything like that. But what I've found to be different is that if you are in the niche that you like, then it's not really so much of a challenge, as you're talking about something that you're already comfortable speaking about. And so you can grab the camera or a phone and just record yourself speaking, and chances are, after the third time, it won't be as bad as you thought it would be. Now, I'm going to talk about the faceless channels because most people are usually interested in that, and I'm going to start with the pros of the faceless YouTube channel. Now, one challenge or one problem that I can see with a personal branded channel is that it's not as scalable as you would think. You can only make so much content. Now, there are YouTubers who post 3+ videos every single day without stopping, and I've tried it, and I think I made it to 3 days of posting multiple videos per day, and it wasn't something that I could do. Even so, posting one video every single day is difficult, and you'll have to really have good time management to consistently pull that off. So the first pro is that you don't create the content or 100% of the content with a faceless YouTube channel. And so there isn't really a limit to how much content you can produce. Now, you can start creating the content yourself. If the channel grows a lot, you can pay people to create the content for you. And this way, you can scale this channel. And so you can go on to Fiverr, for example, and hire a content producer and tell them the topics, and they'll find the content and put the videos together. And you can hire multiple people to do this, which then allows you to have daily content for your channel. And this then becomes a business where you don't necessarily have to do a lot of the work every single day. And this is actually the biggest pro of a faceless YouTube channel. You can start this channel right now and create content and do the work. But when you grow this channel and you stop to take a step back and outsource everything From there on, you have AdSense revenue, which you can use to pay for outsourcing the work, and then you get free marketing and targeted traffic to your business or your online products where you can get more sales and build email lists. So if you're looking at this in the long term, a faceless YouTube channel will do well if your end goal is to automate the channel and then step back and work on something else, or maybe even create other niche faceless channels. Now, the con to having a faceless YouTube channel is that you have a lower trust factor. Sure, people will watch the content and you can make money from the YouTube Partner Program, but when it comes on to direct sales or selling your own online products, people are more likely to purchase products from people who they can see. So in the previous video, I talked about having an issue with my thermostat and I found a channel which was able to help me. And I watched several videos because I found the first video helpful with my problem. And then I went to their website, and if I needed to purchase anything, I would have used their links or their products. However, if it were a faceless channel, I probably would have searched YouTube again to find a channel where I could see an actual person working through the issue or talking about it. And then I think it would be easier to trust the solutions and purchase recommended products from seeing a real person talking about them than just seeing random photos or video clips and hearing a voice behind it all. So that's the main con that comes to mind when I think about faceless YouTube channels. If you want to utilize other monetization strategies such as product sales and affiliate marketing, I think it will be a bit harder and you'll have to rely mostly on the YouTube Partner Program for revenue or income. So having a personal brand YouTube channel has the opposite pros of the no-face YouTube channel. The most significant pro is that you get to develop that trust with your audience, which makes it much easier for them to want to sign up for your email list or consider purchasing anything you recommend, or even just coming back to see your content. This is also a pro when it comes down to making money, because now you can have additional streams of income apart from the YouTube Partner Program, which includes brand deals. And brands are much more likely to want to approach you and give you deals if you have a personal brand YouTube channel, because it's easy to know who you are and connect with you. And if you take notes, brand deals are usually on personal branded YouTube channels and not really on the faceless YouTube channels. Now, of course, the personal branded YouTube channel has its fair share of cons, and the main con is that it's not scalable as with the case of the faceless channel. You'll have to constantly create content, and while you can get help in preparing your content and making your videos, you'll still need to be the one behind the camera, and you only have a limited amount of time to do this every day. If you're really good and you can produce enough videos to post consistently and regularly, then that's great, but usually you will be limited to posting maybe just a few videos per week. And this is important because remember, the more you post, the more your audience and new people will watch and find your content, and then you can use that traffic to send to your own website or business where you can convert that to sales. So this is definitely something to consider. So think about this and decide if you want to either have a faceless YouTube channel or a branded personal YouTube channel. And if you decide you want to do a faceless YouTube channel, I have a video on how to quickly and easily create content for a niche and do that. And you can find that video here. I'll leave the link to that on the screen right now. And that should help you in getting started. Now, there are other ways to keep your audience engaged and get better results from the free traffic and marketing on YouTube. And I'll talk about that in a follow-up video. Comment below and let me know which one of these channels you'd prefer to start. Would it be a personal branded channel or would it be a faceless YouTube channel? As always, thanks for watching. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you like the content. Subscribe to the channel and hit the notification icon so you can get notified when I post new videos, and I post a new video here every single day on YouTube. Also, be sure to check all the links down below in the description for free and helpful stuff, including Webull, where you can get into investing and get 2 free stocks for using the link valued at up to $1,600. Once again, thanks for watching and I'll see you guys tomorrow.